Yes, this is Vital Tutorial. Today I'll be starting with the basic concept of derivative from the first principle. This is the general rule of the form f of x, that is the function of x. Many of us, it is true that it is obvious that we know the derivative of cos x. If I say what is the derivative of cos x, actually you tell me that it is minus sin s. Yes, it is correct. But I observe that many times, most of us, we do not know how we arrive at minus sin s. So today, I'll be going through that. So I'll start with the general rule of the form f of s. So I will give you some steps and I want you to follow me as I continue. So here, we assume that y is equal to f of s. The first step here is that you make the original equation itself your equation of what? Number 1. So the second step here is you will add your change in y to y and your change in x to s. That is, increase in change in s will lead to an increase in change in y, that is adding change in s to s and change in y to y. So it will be y plus change in y equals to f into s plus change in s. And you make this step equation number 2. This step number 2 now is you will subtract equation 2 from equation 1. You subtract equation 2 from equation number 1. So it will be y plus change in y minus y equals to f into s plus change in s minus f into s. And if you look at this, we observe that y will cancel out y, because y minus y will give us what? 0. And we'll be left with change in y, which will be equals to f into s plus change in s minus f into what? F into x. The next step here is that you divide both sides by change in s. You divide both sides by change in s. Divide both sides by change in s. This will be over change in s equals to f into s plus change in s minus f of s all over change in s. The next step here is that you add the limit as change in s is approaching 0. Take the limit as change in s is approaching 0. Here, I will do it here. So limit as change in s is approaching 0 of change in y all over what? Change in s will be equals to the limit as change in s is approaching 0 of f into s plus change in s minus f of s all over change in s. Note that the limit as change in s is approaching 0 of change in y over change in s is nothing but the y all over what? The s. The limit as change in s approaching 0 of change in y over change in s is nothing but the y over the s. Sometimes they will call it the derivative constant. So me, I love calling it dy over the s. So it will be dy. That shows that if everything here is equal to dy over the s, it means I'll substitute dy over the s for limit as change in s of dy over the s. Of change in y over change in s is approaching 0. I'll substitute dy over the s for it. So it will now be dy over the s equals to the limit as change in s approaching 0 of f into s plus change in s minus f into s, everything over change in s. And here is the general rule of first principle. And in some textbooks or some lecture, you may see this as change in y, dy over the x is equal to the limit as change in s is approaching zero of f into s plus h all over minus f into s everything over h is also correct. It's also correct. See the same thing. Thanks, I remember Jerry. Please don't forget to subscribe, like, comment, and share the links to your the junior ones.